Muy buenas a todos, ¿qué tal? ¿Cómo estáis? Primero soy bien. Hoy en este vídeo quiero compartir más información, más detalles sobre esa empresa que estuve hablando, esa empresa que ofrece software para las máquinas de portación en Estados Unidos, que se llama Tomi algo. Lamentablemente ya no se puede decir su nombre, podemos entender como dominar nuestro mundo. Así que cuando empecé a hacer esos vídeos realmente no tenía recurso o material en español. Hoy, gracias a este medio Tierra Pura, que ha hecho un buen trabajo, un magnífico trabajo, para traducirlo al español para poder compartir con nuestra audiencia. Así que también voy a dejar su link de la web oficial y también su canal YouTube. Si os interesa más información, podéis encontrar ahí. Un abrazo. Hasta mañana.
It's either Semantic or Smartmatic or the two. They're, one is a subsidiary of the other. It's all inextricably intertwined. The money creating it came out of Venezuela and Cuba. It was created for the express purpose of being able to alter votes and secure the re-election of Hugo Chavez and then Maduro. They've used it in Argentina. There is an American citizen who has exported it to other countries, and it is one huge, huge criminal conspiracy that should be investigated by military intelligence for its national security implications.
Dominion, you've raised this, and we saw the letter last night. People like Elizabeth Warren, Amy Klobuchar have raised significant concerns about Dominion. Now they're trying to make it seem like a right-wing, wacko conspiracy concern, even though people like PBS were raising serious issues about Dominion just before the election. I heard you say today, Dominion, the software, was actually designed to be hacked. And I'm looking at one of the agreements they had with the county of Santa Clara on... this is a contract between them and Dominion. Item 226 allows staff to adjust tally based on review of scanned ballot images. Look, you're the lawyer. I'm no tech expert, but that sounds very, very funky to me.
And worse than that, it had a back door so it could be manipulated by anyone who could access it through that back door. And that was a deliberate feature. The affidavit of the young military officer we provided yesterday to the public explains how it was created for that very purpose. So Maduro, Hugo Chavez would never lose another election. And he did not after that software was created. He won every single election. And then they exported it to Argentina and other countries in South America. And then they brought it here. And it's a foreign company, no matter how you look at it. So they've already violated the president's order against foreign interference in our elections. Our votes were actually eventually counted in Barcelona, Spain, or Frankfurt, Germany, on foreign servers. It's absolutely stunning. And what's really stunning is the effort that is being mounted against getting the truth out on this. But you have to realize that every tech company, every media company, every social media company, scads of globalist corporations have been doing business in countries with these dictators that have been installed through this rigged election system for decades. The corruption is actually worldwide. It is going to upset a countless number of elections across this country and around the world.
All right.
So we need to do that to get rid of the corruption.
It does make a lot of sense now how Joe Biden campaigned, i.e. not campaigning. Their team seemed to know something. If this is true about Dominion, and I suspect it is. By the way, so we have these concerns. You've got your whistleblower. Who do you bring this to? But what happens next? What body do you have to implore to take action?
Well, we can add a fraud claim to any of the states in which litigation has already been filed as soon as we can get the rest of the material together that I'm still in the process of collecting because, frankly, witnesses are coming forth every day that are fed up with the corruption in Dominion and in the states and the counties and the country. So we're intaking information at an amazing level of people who want to stop this and are absolutely fed up with it.
You mentioned
the evidence from the own mouths of the guy who founded the company. I haven't even had a chance to get that out to the public yet. But they admit, the founder of the company admits, he can change a million votes, no problem at all.
The founder of Dominion admitted a long time ago, recently to you. Can you tell us more, please?
Publicly. I will tweet out the video later and I'll tag you in it.
Please do. At Greg Kelly USA, if you don't mind. That's pretty wild. Oh, by the way, what can you tell us about, you mentioned briefly the whistleblower. There is a whistleblower. Remember, whistleblowers who are against President Trump are hailed as heroes and deified. What can you tell us about this individual?
The one who gave us the affidavit?
Yes.
He was a high-ranking military officer. He was very close to Hugo Chavez. And he is just absolutely disgusted with what he's seen and was participating in when he was with Mr. Chavez. He saw how it all worked. He was at meetings where it was fully briefed. And he wants this country to not fall prey to the same corruption and tactics that were used in Venezuela.
And I'm sorry, is he an American military officer or a Venezuelan military officer?
He was a Venezuelan military officer. He lives in this country now.
All right. And you mentioned the CIA today. I heard you during a radio appearance. You want the CIA director fired. It seemed a little bit off topic and off message, but what's the tie-in, if you don't mind?
The tie-in is that there's no way these programs could have been run around the world to affect elections without the CIA. They also have had people disclose to us the whole hammer program that was created for the CIA and scorecard, which is essentially the same thing. It seems like every country has used something like this to do what it wants to do. Supposedly ours was invented to influence foreign elections, but that too could have been turned on this election. It's all part of the same part and parcel of government interference in elections to make choices against the will of the people. And the will of the people in this country was that Donald Trump win in a landslide. If we can get to the bottom of it, and I am determined to do that, I think we'll find he had at least 80 million votes. The only reason the glitches happened in the system was because he was had so far many more votes than they had calculated in advance. Their algorithms wouldn't perform the functions they'd originally performed that were set to perform. They couldn't make up the vote count. He had gotten so many hundreds of thousands more than they planned. So that's when they had to stop the counting and come up with a way to backfill the votes or destroy votes for Trump while they fabricated votes for Biden.
Sidney Powell, who is a former federal prosecutor, by the way, spent 10 years working for the federal government. Good luck. And by the way, very quickly, you have evidence. It's coming in fast. There is a reason for not making it public, correct? I mean, you're going to have a hostile media picking it apart, possibly trying to destroy your case before you can even make it. Is that part of your thinking? Very briefly, if you don't mind.
Well, not really. It's a matter of collecting it in the right form and format to be admissible. And we have witnesses that are scared. We have witnesses that are afraid for their lives, afraid for their family. Back in Venezuela, there are all kinds of concerns. People have been threatened, and it's very serious. We're talking about billions of dollars of worldwide wealth here that was all corrupt, and every force the world except 80 million voters, we the people, and my little team seem to be against us.
Well, millions are praying for you and with you, and find her on Twitter. Least we can do. Sidney Powell 1, at Sidney Powell 1, the numeral 1. We appreciate it so much. Good luck, and please stay safe.
Thank you, Greg. You too.
All right. Take care now.